it comes. How's everyone tonight? Oh my lord! Sun, here it comes. My name is Chris Quinlan. Welcome to Melbourne Musos Facebook Live on a Friday at 6 o'clock. Now this show tonight, I hope it's a bit uplifting, but I'm going to call this show More Changes Than English Prime Ministers. Yeah. Wow. Bloody hell. You know, sliding doors or whatever it is. Bloody hell. Oh, my Lord. Okay, so what I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to talk about time signatures, but in a very different way. What has more changes than English Prime Ministers? Well, I'm going to start with the Beatles. Okay, so what I'm going to really do tonight is I'm going to first of all talk about, I'm going to center in on three things tonight, three songs or two songs and a piece of music that is an absolute masterpiece of timing. And the first of all, what I'd like to talk about, I mean, I obviously started the tonight show with the classic Beatles, George Harrison's Here Comes the Sun. Some consider it almost the perfect pop song. That middle section. Ah, oh, poor Ringo. I love Ringo. I think he's absolutely... The people that hang it on him haven't heard him and have cloth ears for mine. He is a champ. And what it is I'm going to start with time signatures. Now, of course, I've talked about time signatures before. It's a drum show. But what goes on is that with what I'm doing here, how do you change it up? How do you do different things? So tonight I'm going to talk about the bottom number. A time signature, the top number, when you have 4-4, the top number is 4. So you count to 4. It's pretty easy. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's so easy they call it, and so popular they call it common time. That's what it is. Sometimes if you see a capital C, what will happen is that is common time, 4-4. But what happens about the bottom number? The bottom number tells you the type of note that gets the beat. So what happens is that when we're talking about these kinds of beautiful songs, they're not that easy sometimes. Ooh, and what happens is, I've got this trusty 101 Beatles songs for buskers. I got a Beatles complete over there as well. And I've got another book from my youth in the other room, Beatles Fantasy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's the boys. Anyway, I'm going to song 35, Here Comes the Sun. And I'm getting stuck straight into it. And I apologize here, but I'm now going to take this camera here. Hello. And what I'm going to do is press... the middle section, sun, 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 here it comes. So what we've got, and I'll try and talk it to you as well, but here with the camera here, we've got a bar of 3/8, another bar of 3/8, a bar of 5/8, one bar of common time, 4/4, a bar of 2/4, and then another bar of 3/8. Cool, blimey, mate. So you get 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 1, and it keeps on going 4 times, and then a fifth time it goes into the next section. So there it is there. Now, it'll be on this tomorrow, okay? So that's what happens there. Now, I'm going to, as I said, what I'll do is I'll just very quickly... I'm going to grab it again in just a second. But what I'm going to do is very quickly talk about the bottom number. When you have, like, just quavers, like that, okay? So what happens is if you've got 4-4, it's equivalent to 4 quarter notes in the bar, crotchets, right? So it'll be 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. The ands are important. When you have the bottom number, like if you have 4-8... 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2. 4, 4, 1, 2, 1, 3, and 4, and 4, 8. 1, One and two and three and four and one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So what you have is these wonderful changing of time signatures because of the bottom number and the change of the pulse. And that's what goes on there. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to that snippet which I've put onto the sampler here, which I play to. And what I'm going to do is use this camera here to point to it while it's playing. Here we go. Here it comes. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, and 2. Hey! I made a mistake. I'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 4 5 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 1 2 3 1 2. Okay. Now what I'm going to do. Oh, get this out of the way. Oh. 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 3 1 And there you go. What happens then is that you've got shifting time signatures there. Now I'm going to pull out another one. Oh, I got bits and pieces everywhere here. So that's the Beatles' Here Comes the Sun off of the Abbey Road album. Classic album, brilliant album. Now, if we go to Sgt. Pepper's, what we have now is we have A Day in the Life. I read the news today, oh boy. England is going to have a new prime minister. He'll be or she will be the third one in a year. That's even worse than Straya. I rhymed. Hello, audience. Anyway, so what we have now is the middle section of A Day in the Life off of the Sgt. Pepper's album, 1967. Arguably their classic album, but what it is this one. I've got the setup for this one here, and it's the middle section. So, here we go. That bit. Song. Now here we go. I should be drumming to this, but anyway. Now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Ho 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 ho! Na na na. There we have it. I hope you enjoyed that. Acting the clown. Now, back to our trusty camera here. What we have now. I'll put in a little pencil mark here. Now, what happens is the orchestra really revs up. It's not written in the old busker book. I mean, you know, it's got a lot of these song books have a little double bar line when the big instrumental thing comes up. Ah, you don't need that. Yes, we do. Except then the book will be 200 pages long. Anyway, there you go. Now, what happens is I put a little pencil mark here for the actual sampled part. It's, I don't usually do that. I just put that in today. But for where I started it, bump, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six. Then it's got a bar of 4/8, a bar of 5/8, then a bar of 6/4, and then a bar of 4/4, another bar of 4/4, then a bar of 4/8, and then another bar of 4/4, yet another bar of 4/4, another 4/8, a bar of 4/4, another bar of 4/4, and then nya na na na, and then you're off. Okay, so that's what goes on. So when you're starting, at least with this sampler, I'm going to start with the 8 and the 6. Okay, so here we go. All right, I'm going to lose the first bit by pressing the button, but here we go. 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. There it is!
Hello.
There you go. That's it. I'll pick that back up. Oh. Oh, I might as well start playing. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. Two, three, four, five. One, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, two, and three, and four, and one, two, three, four, one, two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, two, three, four, two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and. I just saw a riff on it very quickly. I didn't mean to do that. Anyway, I did. So that's what happens there. Now, what you've got there is that when you're dealing with this kind of business, you've got more changes than an English Prime Minister. And what happens here is that you learn to work your numbers. Now, you probably noticed that what I did there was I just went into. When you listen to it, have a listen to Ringo.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Woke up, fell out of bed, dragged a comb across straight. My head. Found my way downstairs and drank a cup. And looking up, I noticed I was late. Found my coat, grabbed my hat, made the bus in seconds flat. Thank you.
And that's that beautiful middle section, you see. So that's what goes on there. And as I said, lots of changes.
Oof.
There you have it. What it is that when we're dealing with Igor Stravinsky, let me tell you a tale. Back when I was doing my HSC, long before VCE, we had to go out and buy the book. Oh, I love this piece of music, The Rite of Spring. Le Sacre du Printemps. Hey, okay, I'd like to buy some cheese. Anyway, so what happens is that this piece of music was groundbreaking, so controversial that they threw lettuce that outlasted Liz Truss at New Rave and the dancers and all that, because it was just out of this, off this planet at the time in 1914. The big premiere, just look it up. Oh, it caused a sensation. And what it is I had to study this for HSC, now it's VCE, as I said, year 12, history and lit, and go through it. And oh my Lord, the things I did. Now, a lot of you know that I started delving into triggers a long time ago, around about 2011 or so. I got my first set of four, and now I've decked out the whole Doris. Hello, Doris. I decked you out, love. And there goes what happens is that what happens with Igor Stravinsky is that with Le Sacre du Printemps, what he wanted to do was in the opening section, what it was, the first section is the Augurs of Spring. And what it is he wanted to create a sense of timelessness, okay? Just timeless. He just wanted the music floating. And then it came in like boom, boom, boom. So what started to happen is you get the opening thing, but like, what is it again? I could look, but I think it's the core anglais. Core. So you go and you get this. I'm having a bombasm in my pants. Oh, so bombastic. Now, what happens there? Funnily enough, it's all in 2-4. Okay, I'll play it out for you. I'll count it out for you here. One and two and 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 one and two one and two and one and two and one and two and two and one and two and one and two and one and two and two and one one and two and one and two and two and one. There you go. Cookie Monster coming over. There you go. Bang, bang. He was playing death metal in 1915. He and Shostakovich, Dmitri, drumming with Dmitri. If they had heavy metal drummers in the 1910s, they would have used them. Bang, 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 bang. There it is there. Ooh! Now, years ago, I actually did it. I went to the trouble of doing a drum set version of it. And that's my chart. These are my charts for it. And what I'd had then was essentially the Le Sacre du Printemps. As I said, it has more time changes than an English prime minister. I've done that joke to death now. There you go. But it is timely. And what goes on is that I've got there for trigger drum set. And what I did at the time, I only had four triggers, which was great because it was the piece itself is quite minimalistic as far as it's it has very snippets, melodic fragments and repetitive. So it's perfect. It was perfect for the drums. So I've got the notes actually written out, you know. So I'd have at the time my interface, I would tune to each movement. And the notes for the introduction was C, B, G, E, B, A. That was the line. And then it was C, D, E, F, G, just the straight up half of a major scale, basically. Don't ask me to sing, I'm a drummer. But what happens is there it is there, and I'm going to put that up now. Sue! Oh! I'm going to riff and make lots of mistakes, I suppose. Oh, I've got Stravinsky. Igor! Play the Beatles, mate. Can you do horses, mate? Horses? Watching. Oh my lord, what a song. Guess what I'm playing after this up with a bit of pity. Alright, I'm out of here. I'll have this all up tomorrow. My name's Chris Quinlan. This is Melbourne Musos Facebook Live on a Friday where we have more English prime ministers than hot dinners, mate. There you go. Oh, go off and listen to the Beatles and Igor Stravinsky.
Frankenstein.
You're putting me on.
No, it's pronounced Frankenstein.
Do you also say Frederick?
No, Frederick.
Well, why isn't it Frederick Frankenstein?
It isn't, it's Frederick Frankenstein.
I see.
You must be Igor.
No, it's pronounced Igor.